CMS, guess what?
What?
We have been waiting for a while, but we finally get a chance.
Chance at what? The lottery? World peace? Tacos?
No, silly. Tomahawk Talk.
Well, it is about time. Sit back, guys, and relax. Tomahawk Talk is on the air.
Almost spring, and
love is in the air.
No, Breslin. State assessments.
Boo!
All students will be completing a state assessment in reading and math. 8th graders will complete a science assessment, and 7th graders will complete a social studies assessment.
Currently, math is testing this week, and then in April we will have science and ELA. Those dates include April 3rd, 4th, as well as the 9th and 12th. So good luck today on the math, and make sure you prepare yourselves for the science and ELA.
A good way to prepare is making sure you get a good night's sleep and make sure you're eating breakfast.
Yum, I'm hungry.
What?
I was looking at the to-do or donut flyer and suddenly got hungry.
To-do or donut?
Yeah, the play being put on by Kermit Jax for a senior project.
Oh yeah, I heard about that. It has several of our CMS students involved in that. It starts at 6 tonight.
I hope they're handing out free donuts, because if they are, I'm in the front row.
I doubt they're giving away donuts, but it costs you $3 to attend. Okay, Brez, let's take a quick break, and when we return, Ashton will catch you up on the weather.
When it comes to vaping, the truth can get clouded. So let's make it clear. Vaping is not safe for youth.
Because vaping can put microscopic particles into your lungs.
And dangerous things like metals into your body.
And nicotine, which can harm a person's brain development through their mid-20s.
With appealing flavors, high nicotine levels, and lots of promotion on social media.
Many kids think vaping is harmless, but it's not.
So talk to your kids about the risks of vaping.
Because when you talk, they hear you.
Hey guys, Ashton Carrier with the latest in Tomahawk Talk weather. The week started so nice as we saw temperatures near 80 degrees, but then a cold front hit Tuesday, late afternoon, and we even saw some snow fly. The weather is trending up, but will it continue? Let's find out. Temperature will be nice for this time of year, but we are expecting some showers in the area, cloudy skies, and a high of only 65. But don't worry, we will see some sun on Saturday. The bad side of it is that the high will only get to 59. Due to the clouds staying around, warmer air will be trapped, and it will allow our temperatures to rebound back to 64. Then on Monday and Tuesday, we start to see a warm-up. Monday will be partly cloudy and a high of 69. Tuesday is even warmer, as the sun will be out a little bit more, and we should see a high of 73. There's a chance of rain the next 2 days, but temperatures will stay in the mid-70s. Spring break is around the corner, and if these temperatures stick around, it could be a nice break weather-wise. For Tomahawk Talk Weather, I'm Ashton Carr, sending it back to you two in the studio.
Thanks, Ashton. Hey, Zoe, did you hear there are two vaccinations that are required for 7th grade? They are Tdap and MCV. Kids often get these boosters when they're 11 or 12 years old. It's important to make sure some sort of documentation is given to the school nurse so she may get their record up to date.
Breslin, these vaccinations are required by the state to attend school. Not having these vaccinations will lead to exclusion or not being able to start school at the beginning of the year. You may email a copy to CMS at the CMS school nurse, Comer J at USA204.net. She will get them entered.
If you have any questions regards to this, feel free to reach out to her or contact the front office. Okay, let's take another quick break, and when returned, Aiden will bring us up to date on sports.
If you're talking, they will hear you.
Why are we getting killed like this?
Kyle's not here. Got caught drinking beer in the park a couple of nights ago.
Really?
Yeah. Zero tolerance. He's out for the season.
Harsh.
Hey, he knew not to drink. We've made that clear to all of our kids, right?
No, not really.
Bill, if we don't tell them what we expect and why they shouldn't drink, how are they gonna know?
Talk. They hear you. For more information, visit underagedrinking.samhsa.gov.
Hi CMS, Aiden here with a look at Tomahawk Talk Sports. Basketball is over, and that means only one thing. Track is getting ready to start. We sent out a few reporters to talk to a few of those planning going out for sports.
How do you feel about track season starting next Monday?
I feel good.
What events are you going to do?
Probably 400
and 400. Who's your favorite coach? Steph. What's your favorite track meet?
Probably
the one we had at home. Did you go to
KPL?
Yeah. How do you feel about the new league? Right.
I think we're going to still win.
How do you feel with the new track starting next Monday?
Hey.
What events are you going to do?
Hurdles and whatever the coaches pick, hurdles and all
that. Who's your favorite coach?
Bryce.
What's your favorite track meet?
Tommy.
Did you go to the KGO?
I don't remember.
It's the last track meet of the
league. Yeah.
Well, how do you feel about the new league we're in?
I'm not scared. I mean, it's good.
How do you feel about track season starting next Monday?
Nervous.
What events are you going to do?
100, 400, and 400.
Who's your favorite coach?
Brad.
What's your favorite track meet?
The Tomahawks.
Did you go to the KVO?
Yeah.
How do you feel about the new league?
Good. I like
those
schools.
Shut up. How do you guys feel about track season starting next Monday?
Great.
Good.
What events are you guys planning on doing?
The 100 possibly, long jump possibly. I don't know. 4x1, long jump, 100, and then all the one.
Who's your favorite coach?
Brad.
Yeah, Brad.
what's your guys' favorite track meet?
The Tongi.
Yeah.
Did you guys get in the KBL?
Yes.
How do you guys feel about the new league we're in?
So great and bad at the same time because they're bigger and better.
How do you feel about the track season starting next Monday? What events are you going to do? Who's your favorite coach? What's your favorite meet you've been to?
Bad.
Did you go to the KVL? How do you feel about the new league we're in?
It's fine.
How do you feel about the track season starting next Monday?
How do you feel about the track season starting next Monday?
I'm very excited.
What events are you going to do?
100 and 400.
Who's your favorite coach?
Mr. Brad.
What's your favorite track meet you've been to?
Probably the first one we went to, which was Tomahawk, I think.
Did you go to the KVL?
No.
How do you feel about the new league we're in?
Excited, but nervous at the same time.
Thanks, ladies. With track starting and spring break right around the corner, that means a couple of things. First, school's on the downward swing. Second, Royals baseball and the Monarchs will be taking the field, and Sporting KC will hit the pitch. Make sure you check us out next week as we will sit down with both the boys and girls track coaches to get a sense how they will see this year's team. That will do it for sports this week. I'm Aiden Bartholomew Krause, sending it back into the studio. Wow, thanks Aiden. Basketball is over and the final sport of the year is getting ready to start.
But don't forget that spring break is approaching and third quarter is about to end. Make sure you get your grades in order.
Well said, Breslin. Well, CMS, that does it for us. For Breslin Sipanik, I'm Zoe Chapman. Have a great weekend, Braves.